Hello students, today we will verify Norton's theorem. According to Norton's theorem, any linear, active and bilateral network consisting any dependent or independent sources, let it be current source or voltage source, that network can be replaced by a current source in parallel with a resistance. That current source is short circuit current and that resistance is internal resistance across some open circuit terminal. In our case here in figure 1, we need to find load current IL across some load resistance RL. Now, in order to do so, first thing which we will do is we will replace load resistance with short circuit and find short circuit current across it. As shown here in figure 2, this ISC is short circuit current. To calculate the short circuit current, we must know the value of this I. The value of this I is voltage source divided by R1 plus R2 into R3 divided by R2 plus R3, which is shown here. Now, value of this short circuit current is this I multiplied by R3 divided by R3 plus R2. In the next step now, we need to find internal resistance of circuit. That is done by replacing voltage sources by short circuit and current sources by open circuit, as shown here in this figure 3. This RINT is internal resistance of our problem. This RINT is calculated using this formula R2 plus R1 into R3 divided by R1 plus R3. After this step, we have both ISC, which is short circuit current, and RINT, which is internal resistance. After having both of them, we can easily find load current IL using the formula ISC into RINT divided by RINT plus RL. In this way, Norton's theorem would be verified very easily. Now let's do it on virtual lab using this link. When you will click to this link, this window will pop up. Window is having some theoretical part which we have just discussed, the procedure, all the steps which we need to follow, operating environment, simulator, quiz and references. Let's go to the simulator part first. This is the simulator part. In simulator part here, we are having this S1, this S2. We need to place our power at S1 first and our load at S2 first for case 1. We can have different values of this R1, this R3, this R2 here. This is our ammeter, this is our voltmeter. In case 1, when we will simulate, we will find load current IL, something as this, 0.28387, using this ammeter. In case 2, first part, we will apply S1 with power only. But at S2, we will short circuit this problem. Now, by doing this, we will be able to find the short circuit current using simulator, which is this 0.67692. Now, at the second case, part 2, we will replace S1 with short circuit and S2 with power. Now we will be able to find Norton's resistance, current and voltage V2, everything. Voltage V2 is 100, current is 0.50, and Norton's resistance here is 216.67. Hence we already have RN and ISC with us. Using this RN and ISC in case 3, we can easily find load current just by simply clicking the simulate here. Now we will fill data to the table. We have all these data with us. In this way, we have successfully verified our Norton theorem. We also have option of many gauges. You all are supposed to do all these problems for the sake of your practice and references. This was all.